Welcome to our automated Halloween prop video. Now this is the fourth of four videos, so if you missed the first three, please go back and watch them before continuing on. Now in this video, I plan to show you how to fully automate our pneumatic system we've previously created. And for ease of demonstration, I'll leave our original two setups for reference and I'll create a complete new third system. Now in this system, I'll still use an electrically operated pneumatic solenoid valve and I'll still use a photo sensor. Now the difference is I'm going to incorporate a controller or a PLC to control the solenoid when it's turned on and how long we want it on. Maybe I'll show you how we can trigger the air cylinder to move in a back and forth motion a few times. Now this system will have a standard two-port air cylinder like this one versus the spring return style that we had previously used. So you'll either have to use two small solenoids to control it or a two-way solenoid valve like this one. It's called a three-port five-position valve, and I'll explain a little more on the differences later. Now I have several two-port air cylinders here. Your requirements may differ, and you may want more travel like one of these large cylinders here. I plan to use this smaller one for ease of space in this demo. Also, if I'd have chosen to use one of the large air cylinders, I would need to take into account for larger air volume needed in order to move the cylinder rapidly. Now this means I would have to use larger fittings, larger air tubing, larger hose, larger capacity air valves. So keep all of these factors in mind when selecting your parts. Okay, so I picked up a small PLC called the Click, and I did this for three reasons. A, it's self-contained, so no additional parts or I/O cards are needed. B, it's very inexpensive. And C, the software is free. Oh, and since this is Automation Direct, I had a few of them lying around. So, no need to overcomplicate the project, right? Now, we still could have used a DL05, a DL06, a DL105, or even larger, since we can get a limited free version of the DirectSoft. But the Click still is inexpensive and the software is easy to use, and it leaves us with tons of capabilities to expand if we need to. In other words, if we ended up wanting to use 10 or 20 of these automated systems in a haunted house, we could control each one of them in the same or different ways, or pretty much the whole haunted house with this one PLC. Now first, let's take care of the plumbing side of this. We still plumb our main air source into the manifold or solenoid valve. Now, I'm using a three-port valve, so we have a supply in and then two ports out, and we still have our two exhaust ports. Now this valve is called a three-port five-position with center closed. It's part number AVS-523C1-120A. This means that we can trigger air to one side to make the cylinder extend out, and then trigger air to the opposite side to make the cylinder retract in, or trigger the valve to return to center, and it closes off all ports and keeps pressure on both sides A and B, which allows the air cylinder to stay in its current position. Otherwise, if the center was exhausted, the cylinder would be able to travel by force or gravity to either side A or side B. Now, I probably could have used the same spring return style cylinder and one solenoid valve, but the direction I chose in this last prop gave us more flexibility and control. Next, we plumb the two ports that will supply the air to the pneumatic cylinder. And as I mentioned earlier, I will use these adjustable flow control fittings here. They'll allow us to adjust the air pressure at the cylinder in order to speed up or slow down the flow. Now this makes the action smoother and prevents damage to our cylinder. Now that the system is plumbed, let's get wired up. Now this may get a little bit more complicated than the previous system, and again, if you don't have the skills or the knowledge to work with electricity, we suggest hiring or finding someone that does so you and your system can remain safe. So first, we need to wire up the AC photo sensor we have. It's identical to the last system. This time, we'll wire it to the X1 input of our PLC. Next, we wire up the outputs Y1 and Y2 on the PLC to the solenoids. Now an extra step I'm going to make is to incorporate a suppression diode on each output. Now the reason why is solenoids can generate a spike in voltage and it'll send an overvoltage to the PLC. To avoid damaging the PLC, we'll use these diodes and they'll suppress or capture the spike. Now I'm using a ZipLink module that we sell here at Automation Direct. It's part number ZL-TSD8-120. It's very inexpensive to use and will save you money and headaches in the long run. Now the last step is to wire up the power to the PLC itself. Now again, we have a complete 120 volt AC system, so we needed to use this power supply because the Click PLC requires 24 volts DC to operate. Now if we had chosen to use a 24 volt DC system, we could omit this part and just powered our Click PLC from the main 24 volt power source, like one of these. Now last is program the PLC. I won't go into great detail on programming, but simply show you how I programmed this system with a few lines of code. Now we offer detailed programming videos and training videos here at Automation Direct, and if you need further instruction, we have the resources for that. Now the code I use said if the sensor is triggered, it turns on input X1. This will in turn activate Y1 output and extend the alien head out. Since we want the head to stay out, I'll use a timer to start timing. I have timer T1 turned on, and it times for 5 seconds. Once T1 has reached its set time, we turn off output Y1 by resetting it and turning on output Y2, which retracts the head. So if someone trips the sensor, it'll start the cycle, run through and reset, and be ready for the next cycle. Now let's change the code and make the head move back and forth. Input X1 turns on, setting an internal bit and turning on timer T1. Timer T1 is set to time to 15 seconds. In those 15 seconds, I put compare statements every few seconds telling the output Y1 to turn on. As you can see on rung 4, if the value of the timer is greater than or equal to 1, and the value of the timer is less than or equal to 2, then we turn on the output 1. We don't do this directly because I'm using internal C bits to trigger the output. Now, like I said, there are many ways to do this and achieve the same results. You get the picture, right? So when I put the PLC in run mode and trigger the sensor, you can see what happens. Okay, I'm happy that we were able to show you so many ways to achieve the same results, and I hope you're able to stop by Automation Direct's website and pick up a few parts of your own, and be on your way to creating your own automated Halloween prop, or just something fun. And please, if you create something cool, drop us a line or a link to your system in the comment fields below. Well, that's if you're watching us on YouTube. We would love to see what you have. And yes, some of the professional haunted prop companies do use our equipment for their props that they sell. Keep in mind, all of the products we've used in this system are products that Automation Direct sells, with the exception of our air compressor. The tubing, the fittings, wires, terminals, even the Teflon tape Automation Direct carries. So keep this in mind for all of your automation needs. Thanks for watching, and we hope to see you again soon.